Welcome to the BF Anderson Technical Report for August the 12th. Just finished an interesting book about Charles Ponzi. And, you know, he was the original Ponzi scheme. Books written in the 1920s, great read. I think the main takeaway that I had from the whole book and the whole story was greed can really be a dangerous emotion, because the man was offering, Mr. Ponzi was offering you a 50% return within 90 days, and sometimes he would offer it within 45 days. And there was no way at all, mathematically, that this was going to work. But people crowded to him, millions of dollars flowed into his coffers. Well, anyway, the end of the story was he ended up getting about 5 years in the federal pen, 7 years in the state penitentiary. Then he was forced to leave the country and moved to Italy, then ended up in Brazil and died in a hospital with about $70 in his pocket. So anyway, just thought it was an interesting book. Check it out. Now, when it comes to the market, we're seeing the NASDAQ here. NASDAQ's been somewhat underperforming for the last couple of weeks. You can kind of see sideways action here, actually somewhat breaking down below the 10-day moving average. It is underperforming the market simply because it's got a very heavy exposure to technology. However, on a long-term basis, the chart looks perfectly fine. We're above the 35-week moving average. Now, on the mid-cap stocks, again, we're still having the same problem, sideways action. You know, there's around 8,000 publicly traded companies, so when you try to bring these indexes in, which are, say, 30 Dow Jones, which would be 30 industrial cyclical companies, you really don't get the total picture. That's why we're looking at these five indexes. Now, you can see here on the New York Composite, you know, a lot of exposure to banks. Interest rates, we're going to talk a little bit about that, is causing a breakout here. So the New York Composite looks very constructive. On the small caps, we're still seeing that rollover. Sideways action. Again, the small cap stocks continue to underperform. The market is really not broadening out, and we'll talk more about that. As you can see here with the S&P 500, no problem. The large cap stocks are doing the best. Very positive uptrend on a long-term basis, actually making new high. S&P 500 looks perfectly fine. The market is healthy, it's just not broad. Now, on the aggression index, you can see a definite downturn here. We're continuing to hold that 40-week moving average. However, because the growth stocks are underperforming the consumer staple stocks, which are considered the value stocks, you're seeing a high here, but lower high. The pattern is not as positive as I would like. Now, on interest rates, this is very interesting what's going on here. We've got a double bottom and then a breakout above the 200-day moving average. You know, as you can clearly see, interest rates may have bottomed here. You know, the jobs report last Friday really triggered this. Then we got inflation numbers this morning that were not very negative. Now, the price of oil continues to go into a downtrend. You know, we got up around 77 up here. We're down into the 60s here. Now, in the financial stocks, as you can see, very constructive, lifting off of a base, moving higher. New lows kind of have picked up. Again, last week we talked about new lows. Keep an eye on them. I mean, when we get over 40 a day for an extended period of time, it can indicate a leaking boat. Now, on the inverted yield curve, no inversion. We were moving in the wrong direction. As you can see, as interest rates have popped back up again, we're getting somewhat of an uptick there. On sentiment, we're somewhat neutral on the AAII bull bear index, neutral. So a little bit of improvement. However, on the put-call ratio, we continue to stay in greed. Now, on the Russell 2000, which is a growth index, you can see here the problem. The growth stocks are underperforming. Now, will they outperform again in the future? Well, they always have, so let's just hope for that. Anyway, we've got a peak here in February the 10th. Came down, moving sideways, and somewhat breaking down a little bit today. Junk bonds are improving, I think, as this infrastructure deal is going through the Congress. Maybe that'll help the junk bond market. And as you can see here, a little bit of improvement junk bond. This is very good because we don't want to see a total drop. So the junk bond ratio compared to treasuries came down to the 200-day moving average, broke it, rallied, broke it, made a higher low. now is making a higher high. So that's it's going into an uptrend. Volatility index continues to be fine. We're in no problem there whatsoever. The market has been somewhat quiet. Here are the financial stocks. The financial stocks are the hottest sector here recently. And this is all due to the fact that interest rates are moving up. So you can see here with the financial stocks, we're breaking out to new highs. On the regional banks even, we're seeing much improvement. China, I thought I wanted to do a head and shoulders pattern here for you. This is the China large cap. You can see the left shoulder of the index, a rally, making a head, coming down, making a right shoulder, breaking below the right shoulder. I would stay clear of China. This is somewhat of a negative pattern. Now, again, on the growth stocks, this is the IBD 50 fund, which is the top 50 growth stocks. You can see the same pattern, top in February, came way down, moving sideways, somewhat breaking down a little bit today. However, I would just say that the growth stocks need to rally. Now, here's the top five. You can see here the emphasis on the financial. Here's Lending Club, breaking out to a new high. This is obviously a lender, and as higher interest rates take on, or the market's discounting higher interest rates, that helps this group. Now, here's a biotech. This is a company involved in the virus vaccine. I would be very aware of this. Now, I would say that, you know, you would want somewhat of a base to form here, but it's breaking down below this area. It needs to hold above 350, but keep an eye on BioNTech. Alcoa, you can see here again, strength in the metals. We got a gap up here, holding the gap, somewhat of a ascending base. Looks very positive. Albemarle, same story. Now, on Albemarle, I think I would want to see it base a little bit, you know, somewhat chasing it here. The actual buy signal came in right here on this point, at this point. Then we got a gap up, another base, and then basically another gap up, another base, another gap up. Very powerful pattern. However, I think I would wait for it to base before I would get involved. Asana, which is software, you can see here the software stocks, somewhat, as the technology group is underperforming, somewhat sideways, is forming a base. If it were to break out above this area here, it could be interesting. So that's it. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thank you very much.